Hi, my name is Annesa Flentje, and I'm a researcher at UCSF. And I study ways that discriminatory processes impact health, and specifically looking at how they might change health at the cellular level.
Well, I grew up in the AIDS epidemic. And so right around the time that I was in elementary school, kids were starting to ask questions like, can you get AIDS from a toilet seat? And what are the different ways that I might get this disease, and how can I be safe from it? So when I was in fifth or sixth grade, the Surgeon General at the time came out with his recommendations for AIDS. It was C. Everett Koop. And he came out with this booklet that was mailed to every American household about AIDS, telling people information about it. And so I took it upon myself to read this booklet in depth and disseminate the information to all of the students at my elementary school, to explain to them how you could get it, what the symptoms were, and tell them more about that disease. So I do social science research, and so generally speaking, the research that I do is with people who are experiencing discrimination or stigma due to something about them. And so what I look at is how discrimination and stigma can actually make people less healthy just by having experienced that discrimination. So, you know, when I think about things that have made me be interested in that, I think it's that like seeing things that aren't fair, that are not equitable, tend to pull me in to do something about that kind of problem. As a social scientist, being in the field means being with people. And as a social scientist working with underprivileged populations, it often means working in communities where people don't have enough food, enough money. You know, some scientists will be in a lab or be out collecting specimens, and I tend to work in places where people don't have enough resources. What I'm the project that I'm in the works of putting together right now is going to look at kind of if there's group differences for people who've experienced a lot of discrimination versus not, if there's group differences in the genes that they're expressing, and specifically genes that would sort of activate your immune system or inflame your body, because generally speaking, inflammation, extended inflammation, can be pretty bad. So you look at this, you can look at this through leukocytes in the blood. And so that's one piece of it. The other piece that I'm interested in is, can psychological treatments, so a cognitive behavioral intervention targeting that stress, can it actually change your genes, so that what genes you're expressing, so that before maybe you were expressing a lot of inflammatory genes, after this intervention, this psychological intervention, can that be reduced so that that stress is not going into your body so much? I think that all signs point to the idea that experiencing a discriminatory event, being called names due to something about you, can actually change the ways that your genes work. And in doing so, can directly sort of affect your lifespan, how long you're going to live, how well you fight disease. If they experience kind of a discriminatory event, that they experience it as a stressor, and that stress actually changes the way that their cells work and the way that they repair themselves and the way that their immune system works. And that's what I'm really interested in. And what I'm also interested in is there something we can do to reverse that? So bad things happen to people. Is there something that we can do in the middle to make it so that their cells don't have to suffer? Well, that's the fun part of being an academic. You get to like have your mind blown all the time by all these new ideas, and it's your job to read about them and study them, and it's a good line of work. Thank you.